with my man's debut single. It's called Just Like, it's from, wait, hey. wait. It's called Just Like Compton, and it's from his new CD, Way Too Funky. Please give it up for DJ Quick.
Finally got a chance to lead the CPT. Off to other cities to trip. No longer just an underground hit. Moving things over for brother made good. I made a name over making tracks for homies in the hood. And now, let me tell a little story about the places that I've been to and the things that I've been through. Like fighting, shootouts, and banging, and trip. All because I came out with a hit. Check it. 1991, while everybody else was smoking the spliffs, I was thinking of the funky hits about hoochies and players and getting drunk and off that bud. I was doing the things they hadn't heard of. But foolish was I to think that it wasn't other cities like this, and they didn't like this. That Compton was the home of the gangster class, where you got blasted, and now that's just a thing in the past. Let me tell you why firsthand. We did a show up in Oakland. The brothers was kicking up sand. To them, banging ain't nothing new, and slanging ain't nothing new. And for every sucker, we done shot, then a shot too. Straight through a low since the 60s, before I was born. Families of hard heads mourn. So I'm just letting you know that if you plan to take a trip to the bank, keep your hand in your clip, because Oakland,
this trip's
not content. Yeah, I'm telling y'all, Oakland,
this trip's not content.
Moving on to St. Louis. They think they be bumping with gold teeth in their mouth, but they still know what's up. In the summer, it's kinda hot, hot enough to make you cuss, yo. And that's why I stayed on the bus. But later on, when it cooled off, we came down and made a couple of friends who put us up in the St. Louis Captain Smith Center with Big Bob, Little Steve, Tojo, Vince, and Rich, and a couple of hoochies. Then they took us to a man named Gus, and his store, he put me down with a Harry bow and shoes galore. That's when I started thinking that this wasn't like home, but then they had to prove me wrong. Later that night, after we did the show, we went back to the after set. And what you know, yeah, Luz and Chris start scrapping and shooting in Missouri. Damn, how could this happen? Now St. Louis,
it's just not cool.
Yeah, y'all, St. Louis,
it's just not cool.
I don't think they know, they're too crazy for their own good. They need to stop watching that Colors and Boys in the Hood. Too busy claiming 60, trying to be raw, yo, and never even seen the show. But now back to the story. We packed up the tour bus one more time and started battling, yo. And if suckers wasn't trying to test, I wouldn't have to wear a bulletproof vest. Now San Antonio,
yeah, it's just like Compton.
Yeah, y'all, San Antonio, bring it down. After about a month on the road, we came home, and I can safely say that LA is a much better place to stay. How could a bunch of suckers in a town like this have such a big influence on brothers so far away? But still, my story ain't over, cause I got one more to tell. And the people of Colorado, they know it well. It was all in the news, and if you don't remember, I had the show I did in Denver. When a punk promoted, it was done in a skating rink. Bougies was loving us, but suckers was ready to bust. To the front of the stage, they threw their gang signs. But I'm getting paid, so I didn't pay no mind. Then I pulled out my brew onto their crazy chest. Then they start throwing soda and messing up my guests. When it was over, two suckers needed stitches. Got cracked in their jaws for being nothing but snitches. Now Denver,
it's just not
content. Yeah, y'all,
Denver,
yes, and you know that, oh,
it's just not content.
St. Louis and San Antonio,
I got one.